Not since the horrors of the Black Plague has our land seen such despair. Almost 2 millennia after Sigmar founded the Empire, the realm is fractured and broken. 3 rival factions claim the Imperial Crown: Marienburg, Middenheim, and Reichland. Lure of power brings the armies of men against one another in a seemingly endless tide of battle. An island of peace in a sea of conflict, Mordheim drew wealth such as the city had never seen into its walls. But with its prosperity came the corruption of arrogance and hedonism and greed. The gods could not long abide the outrages of Mordheim's populace. In the heavens, an ill star appeared. A great twin-tailed comet that some priests warned was nothing less than the hammer of Sigmar. They preached tidings of doom and repentance, but their sermons were ignored. An attitude of rebellious revelry gripped the city as the comet grew ever nearer. The grand festival to celebrate the turn of the year was a mockery of the apocalyptic prophecies. It was then that the hammer fell. The fiery comet plowed through the city, gouging a deep crater in the midst of the poor quarter. The wondrous palace of Count Steinhard was broken. The grand amphitheater shattered. The vast great library blighted by a pall of ash. Fire and smoke decimated the populace, but worse awaited the survivors. A malignant corruption that brought with it mutation and madness. The vile taint of chaos. In the shattered city, strange green-black stones were discovered. Strange energies emanated from these shards. Warlocks and alchemists experimented with these word stones and soon determined that their uncanny properties could work wonders. Word stone could heal the sick, regenerate the old, or even turn base metal to gold. Lust for Wordstone focused Avaricious eyes upon ruined Mordheim. Treasure hunters descended upon the city, vying with both mutated horrors that claimed the ruins as their own, and crusading zealots who sought to prevent the taint from spreading. Inhuman creatures filtered into Mordheim, staking their own claims. An endless pilgrimage of the greedy and ambitious, fighting and dying in a place now called the City of the Damned. Who among you shall die today?
Ooh, sounds lovely. Hello, ladies and gents. This is Mordheim. Another early access game and another Games Workshop tabletop conversion. It's set in the Warhammer universe, the same universe as Warhammer Total War, and I think it's about 1,000 years before the events in that. Basically, as you just saw from the intro, Mordheim was this thriving, great city, and appropriately named City of Decadence and Corruption, and Sigmar was offended by this for whatever reason and threw down this mighty twin-tailed comet, and yea, and the city doth was destroyed, and thou shalt something. Anyway, but now the city lies in ruins. There's all these weird things called Wordstone hanging around, which has all these strange magical properties, and there are several warbands who are fighting each other for this Wordstone for various reasons. Some want to weaponize it, some want to keep it safe, and some just want to sell it and make a shitload of cash. The idea of the game is you choose a warband from one of the army lists, and you build up your warband of about 5 to 10 people. It's a skirmish game, not a war game. And you fight other warbands and do campaigns and gather up Wordstone and sell it and stuff, and as you go through the campaign, your warriors get better and you can buy more kit. The warbands themselves, we've got the mercenaries, which are human Reichlanders or something, and basically the empire in Warhammer is based on the Holy Roman Empire, so very there'll be a lot of people very German sounding. They want to sell it because they're mercenaries. We've got Skaven, who are walking rat men, who are very nasty and stab people in the back and stuff, and their main aim is to weaponize it and stab more people in the back with weaponized stuff. We've got, this is a new one, Witch Hunters. They are basically your Holy Inquisition. Think Witch Hunters, Renaissance, Witch Burnings, and all of that kind of thing. They basically kill you if you so much as recite the wrong verse from Sigmar's holy book or something. They're Sisters of Sigmar, who are the Holy Warrior Order of Priestesses, an all-female faction, who use hammers because you can bludgeon someone to death, but drawing blood is a big no-no, apparently. And, see, their symbol is actually the symbol of Sigmar itself. And finally, the Cult of the Possessed, who are Chaos Worshippers. Now, for those familiar with D&D, Chaos isn't cool like it is in that. It is nasty and has lots of evilness. Basically, if you're in league with Chaos, you probably have tentacles and shit. Now, can anybody guess which warband I'm going to go with? Did you guess mercenaries? You're wrong. Did you guess witch hunters? You're wrong. Did you guess Sisters of Sigmar? You're right.
In the name of Most Holy Sigmar,
because why would I not want an all-female warrior faction?
Your service and dedication to our order has long been in my mind. As High Matriarch, I must put your conviction and valor to the ultimate test.
Yeah, I'm not going to read all that. You can read it at your leisure. But interestingly, the person you just heard is Bertha von Bernstrau, or something like that. She's, like, the top dog in the Sisters of Sigmar, and sometimes you can get her to fight for you, and she is seriously badass. Anyway, as you can see, this is the warband, the war camp, where you set up your warband and can choose what to do next. So, I'm just going to take a look at my warband. And this is my warband leader, Esther van Holzhauser. She's like the main matriarch of the Sisters of Sigmar and has the spells. The rest of them I have to hire. I'm going to hire one hero, a Sister Superior. So I'm going to hire Aloysia Aldenberg for 30 crowns, coins, something. 30 gold coins. That's how much... I don't know what they're called, but whatever they're called, that's how many of them I've got to spend on my warband. The rest of them are going to be henchmen, so I'm going to hire a couple of sisters and a couple of novices. I'll hire Grete Dreschner. And I will hire Angelika Alfieg. Yeah, these names are all sounding very German. And I think I'll hire a novice, Solveig Sturm. And it's always a good idea to have some reserves. I'm going to hire some more novices, Clara Luden, and Janneke Gales. And now that I've got my warriors, I'm going to kit them up. And I'm going to go to the shop. See, what can we buy? Oh, we can buy some heavy armor. So I think I'll buy both of the heavy armor things. Harnesses, suits, whatever. Suits of armor. And I'll buy both of the light armors as well. And I think... What does this pendant do? Chance to pass all alone, fear, terror tests. I definitely want one of those. In fact, I definitely want two of those, and I'm going to get a helmet. Okay, now back to the camp. I'm going to kit these people up. I'm going to give you the heavy harness. And because they're female, obviously, as we all know, they must have great big huge breast guard like that, because that's totally how women dress when they go to battle. And... oh, I can't have both. Okay, I'm going to put the helmet on you. Okay, you can have the other heavy armor, I think. Yeah, nice big pauldrons, which have no ties on whatsoever. They obviously stay on by magic. I've got two helmets. Okay, but I'm going to give you this. One of those. You can have some light armor. And you can have the other pendant. Did I buy a shield? No, I didn't. I meant to. Hold on. Can I get a shield? Yeah, there, let's have a shield. It was one of the henchmen, wasn't it? Yeah, it was you. Yeah, having two weapons isn't a great idea, to be honest. In fact, I'm not sure what in-game advantage it actually gets you. But I'm going to give her a shield. The other one can also have light armor. I don't know who I want the other helmet for, actually. But yeah, I think I'm going to run with this for now. So, here's the campaign map. This is where I do my missions. Both of them will be very similar. So, in actual fact, I'm not sure if it makes any difference. It depends which warband I am. We've also got a calendar here. Today is Marktag 2 Flugzeit 2000. And the next event is in 2 days' time on Besaltag 4 Flugzeit. And they'll have some hired swords. It's always a good idea to keep some money back, because you need to pay your warriors and you need to pay for any treatment. And if you don't get enough wordstone, or if you lose a battle, you end up losing quite a bit of money, so you definitely need to keep some back. I'm going to go for this one, I think. And I'm just going to dive straight in.
An enemy warband is hurrying to recover a secret cache of equipment in the area. With this information, you are able to beat them to the location and deploy patrols to watch for the enemy's arrival.
Basically, I've got to try and rout the enemy warband, but I've also got these two optional musicians. Steal the idol of the enemy warband and secure it in your chest somehow. Don't know if I'm going to be able to do that, to be honest. But anyway...
A new round has started.
This is the turn order along the top here. The question marks are ones I haven't identified yet, so I don't know who's moving at the moment. The actual war game, we all take turns, like one player goes and another player goes, but this acts more like the role-playing game, as in we go in initiative order. So now I've got Solveig Sturm, who is miles away from everyone. Oh, that's just great. the way it works in this, basically, I can move anywhere within this circle without spending any more movement points. You spend one for the initial move, the blue dots at the bottom are the movement points, and basically whenever I cross that line it spends another movement point, so I can go all the way over here, and if I change my mind and actually want to go the other way, I can actually just walk back into those glowing things here and get all my moves back. If I decide it might actually be tactically better to go here, oh god, where is everyone? Of trouble over here, to be honest, and I don't know where the rest of them are. don't even know who I'm fighting, actually. I'm gonna keep her back here for now, I think. Great. I'm gonna put her here, and I'm gonna... What's my dodge better than my parry? Okay, I'm gonna put her in dodge stance, just in case he gets attacked. Okay, this is where everybody else is. Okay, let's see if I can locate Solveig. Okay, there's a big central bit here. I don't want to risk getting hemmed in there, so I'm going to wait here for now. Some nasty stuff around here. What is that burning corpse there? Oh, where are they? See, that's one thing I learned from playing the tabletop game is, as Sisters of Sigmar, if you get isolated, you're pretty screwed. You really need to keep everybody together. I'm gonna climb up there, actually. Oh, that went well. Could attempt it again, but I'm just gonna... Okay, did it that time. Oh, and there's nothing even... nowhere I can even go anyway. Yes, there is, I can go up here. Not from here, I can't. No, I'm going to jump, go back down. Well, that was pointless. Okay, Angelica Alvig. Of them. Okay, I'm gonna try and keep her with the other ones, so I'm gonna put her... That's where she is, so... And you, I'm going to move to... Okay, looks like I'm going to have to go into that central bit because I... Everyone's just so scattered now.
A new round has started.
hard when you don't have a map, because I have no idea where anybody is. Might have to venture forth and just hope for the best. That way. Oh, you know what? I'm going to go up there. Why would you jump up when there's a ladder? Not as much to ambush. All these twisted, misshapen bodies all over the floor. Okay, we're gonna have to go out and try and get everybody together. Not a great parry stance, but thing is, the computer has a huge advantage here because he knows exactly where his people are and how to get them together. I have no idea where everyone is. I was hoping to regroup and be able to pick them off individually, but that's obviously not going to happen now. The other annoying thing about this game is, at least for the moment, there's no way to speed it up. You just have to wait out the enemy's turn, and it happens in real time, and when you can't see what's happening, you just end up staring at your screen for ages. And right now he's doing considerably better than me at getting Wordstone. Well, there's my wagon. Where the hell is everybody else? Alright, there's the Sister Superior. Where'd I put the leader? Oh, there. can't even see any Wordstone. I think they're basically going to get all of it. Action points used at the end of the unused at the end of the turn, then you get a free attack, basically. Or you get a counter attack if they attack you. I think. Not sure though. Uh-huh. Managed to regroup with the others, finally! Okay, so... Solvi can go there. Where the hell are the enemy? Sigmar's might. Will it get both of them? No, it won't. See what I might do though. Don't think I can delay that far though, that's the only thing. Think. They are somewhere on the other side of this building. I don't want to go running off into ambush. Oh my god, I like all of the Wordstones, like, right by him. Yep, he's pretty much going to get all of them. Because I can't even find a single one. Again. I want to do Sigmar's Might on as many people as I can. So I'm going to get her up. Definitely want to get her up, because she's pretty good. Oh, Sigmar! Oh, that's targets. Now I can do Sigmar's Might on those three. Oh, and it failed. After all that, it didn't even work. Okay, so we are on the south side of that, southwestern side of that central building. Let's try it again, because why not? You are now all Sigmar's mighted up.
A new round has started.
Who am I fighting and where are they all? Off gathering all the Wordstone, obviously. I don't want to go too far. Ooh, they've been spotted. And it looks like it's possessed that I'm fighting. Delay! So I kind of want to activate her when the rest of the enemies are there because... Okay. So the others should be, if I've done this right... Oh, there they are. There's the wagon, and that is not where I want to be. So this is obviously a different... Great big central building. Oh, great. Although we can scout the area, actually. We have two of them right there. Which means the other three are out in the field somewhere. But where are my guys? Or girls, should I say. No idea now. One thing I've learned from playing the possessed against the possessed is fighting them alone is a very bad idea. Pretty much need to mob them with everyone I've got, and even then it's touch and go. There, I see one. Try and spring that ambush and bring him there, because I've got these two yet to move. Oh no, I can't. were two of them by the wagon, so if he's got five, then he should have another. He should have three out here. Which means there's him and two more. Just this guy.
A new round has started.
Oh, it looks like they've all been revealed. Which means they're all nearby. Yeah, there's the other one. No, I'm gonna have to wait for him to come to us. And you missed. Of course he doesn't miss. Oh, he did that time. Okay, so one of them's engaged, which is good, because that means I can now hopefully take this guy out, because she gets two attacks. Oh, God, these guys are tough. And that's exactly what I was hoping wouldn't happen. Right, it's just these two now, so we've got to try and take one of them out of the fight. She still can't get in on the action. Great. Oh, seriously? Yeah, I just saw one of them go past there. So I'm hoping they're going to stay divided from the main force for a bit longer, just so I can take these. Oh, there's that guy. Okay, so watch out for that. Now can you get round the back and finish this guy off? No, of course you can't. Second attack. Bloody hell, what's this guy made of? Yeah, she probably not use that armor, because if you can't dodge. I'm hoping he's going to fail the all alone test now. Oh, still no. Ha, that's good. Come on, finish him off. Nice. And now, get into combat with this guy. He's going to take a lot more hammering, I guess. He's probably going to get two attacks, though. Okay, so that guy was over there, wasn't he? Yeah, I can see him. So let's not go there. There is nothing I can do. I can't even get her in the fight. Yeah, of course the parry failed, but he can dodge. Oh, there he is. That's good. If I can give him the runaround for a while, I can take him out of the fight for a bit. But where's that guy? I think that's one of the big ogre type guys, and they're pretty tough. So not looking forward to facing that one. Okay. No! So much for your dodge. 15% is probably not really worth it. Now, can I get her in the fight as well if I go there? Does she get another one? Come on. Nice. That's two of theirs down. Question is, can I get his wordstone? Yes, I can. And we'll grab his hammer as well, just because. He hasn't got any wordstone. Grab a dagger though. A 0% dodge ability.
A new round has started.
Okay, so he's got three guys up, and I've got all five, which is pretty good, actually. But I still need to get Greta in the fight. Ooh. Have they deserted their wagon? Sigma, I bless thee with my might and stuff. Okay, that guy was chasing after me there, so I'm just gonna have to keep on giving him the runaround, I think. Oh, damn it, why did I ambush? There's big ogre grunt thingy guy. Oh, I still haven't located. Oh, there he is. That's someone. I can take this guy out. That's not him, that's that other leader who's back there chasing Greta, isn't it? Charge, actually. I can. Yeah, let's go for it. Charge! Oh, damn it, it missed. Disengage. But I can't do anything else.
A new round has started.
So, pointy hat guy is out there somewhere, and I don't know where. Oh, you know what? I should have left her in battle with that guy. I'm going to put her here and charge. God damn it. In fact, let's do Sigmar's might and then attack. Can I charge? No, I can't. Can hit him, though. Eat that. And that. Where's the guy with the pointy hat? That is a dead end. But if I can get this guy next turn, then it could win this game for me. I still have no idea where they are, though. Actually, is that it? Where the blue... That's my... I think that's my chest where the blue glow is. Oh crap, I don't think she can get in. Oh, damn it. No fair. Okay. Okay, I didn't notice that before. The red glow is his chest and the blue glow is mine, so... All I really need to do is head towards the red glow. And I need to get their symbol and bring it over to the blue glow if I have time, but something tells me it's not going to last that long. Come on, you've got to fail this. You've got three people on you. What is he doing? What is he doing? Something's not quite right here. standing around by his chest, not doing anything, but I think this may well have crashed, to be honest.
...50% of Wordstone claimed. A new round has started.
Okay. He's back. That's good. At least we can continue. Because you can now... Ha! Eat that. Oh, right. You can't. Actually, you know what? Do that, because I think you're the last person. I want to see if you can get that one. And I wonder... I want to get to his chest. Anyway, he's just got the wizard and that leader over there.
A new round has started.
And he failed the route check, which means I win the battle. Okay, this is the report. The that's my warband, the Mercies of Matriarch Magda. And I was fighting the Cult of the Thousand Eyes. And as a reward, I got one of those Wordstone fragments and two of those, plus the two I managed to pick up. Okay. The idea of this isn't to kill anyone, it's to try and rout them.
Never fear defeat.
Because if they drop below 50%, they have to take a rout test. And if they fail, then basically you win. That's pretty much how it works in the board game as well. You can also choose, if you're losing too many, you can choose the voluntary route,
you
where you save whoever's left, but you basically forfeit that battle.
Completed.
And now, the results of the battle. I don't think anyone actually went out of action, but as you can see, everybody gets experience for surviving the mission and for acts within the mission, and they get advances. So, this tells you what everybody's got. Survived the mission but didn't do much. And nobody's actually wounded, which is nice. And that's all the stuff I managed to loot, as well as what I picked up during the actual battle itself. So, end of the battle, we now go back to our warband. We've got to pay everyone who took part. If they was injured, I would have to pay treatment, but more importantly, I get to advance them. Now, she gets a mental advance, which I believe, as a leader, she'd probably want this one most. She also gets a mental advance, and again, she needs to be paid. She doesn't actually have any spells, so... I'm going to do that. And I think until I can start pumping her agility a bit, I'm going to keep the armour on her, because the dodge is probably not going to work. she doesn't get any advances, neither does she. Or Solvig. And yep, that's the advance is done. Now, I can also go to the shop and sell some of the stuff I picked up. For example, I don't think I want this heavy armour, so I'm going to sell that. Not sure I want this helmet actually either, so I'm going to... But no, I'll hang on to that. So yeah, I have done everything I can. I can't do another campaign today, so I'm going to have to advance the time and go next day. Make sure you've taken care of all your business and paid up keep with a crew at the end of the condition. Okay, so
a new shipment has been requested.
So on Bakatar 3 Flugsite 2000, I have received a new shipment request from Bertha Bestraufrung. That's the one I meant. the name I couldn't remember. So basically, I've got 10 days to deliver a crap ton of wordstone to Bertha Bestraufrung to keep, obviously, to keep it safe. I'm sure she totally doesn't want to do anything with it. So yeah. So yeah, that is Mordheim. Interesting looking game, still in development, so some of this might change. I don't know what. There might be more warbands added, they might change some of the weapons and some of the functionality. I hope they add slings for my Sisters of Sigmar, because they kind of use them quite a lot in the tabletop game. And yeah, I guess that'll be all for now, so I'm gonna call it a day. Bye now.